All right. We're up. We're live. We're going. Here we go. Friday. Happy. Happy Friday. Need my workout. Hold on. All right. I need my water as well. But first minute of our warm-up. Cardio, whatever you got. You got a machine? Get down there. You got your jumping jack. You got jump rope. Jogger on the block. Whatever the case may be. All right. Got a good one set up for you today. You can use us as your partner. All right. Nice partner workout. Figure out what all that means shortly. Let's get warm. Everything looks good. All right, guys. Sumo squats. You know those. I gotta fix my accent. I don't know what's going on. I gotta get my water. All right. A little lunge and reach. Got my water, ready to hydrate. Got my phone for no reason. And we are on our third minute. Yes, back to some humidity today. Not crazy bad, but certainly warm enough to notice. But I think it's good. Holding on to some summer. Everyone is enjoying their summer as well. Wrapping things up, getting the kids ready for school. A lot of college kids already gone back. High school kids later. A couple weeks here in SK. Getting last minute shopping in for everything. We've got plank swings here on our warm up. I like to put both hands on the ground. And just use it as a good stretch, right? It doesn't have to be a cardio thing and go fast. It doesn't have to be a challenge thing with one arm. It's a stretch. A little downward dog, upward dog, back and forth. Stretch out those shoulders. Get those hips up in the air. You can get a good stretch in the back of the legs. You can get the Achilles stretched out. Utilize this exercise. Get that stretching going. Everyone could use more stretching in their life, right? All right, what's up next? Gonna hang out down low as we go to our side lunge to our instep stretch. More stretching. Yep. Time on these instep stretches, really get those hamstrings, hip flexors, work it all. A little spinal twist in there. All good, useful stuff, guys. Nice job. Let's go to our skaters next. Skaters, little side to side. All right up. All right, got some stretching, the blood's flowing. All right, guys, nice job. Okay, we're going to our squat to stand next. I think one of the most important stretches you could possibly do. Really opens up the hip flexors, really helps get your knees stronger. Believe it or not, stretches them out. Kind of really can, I think, get all your sit muscles relaxed a little bit. And again, hip flexors, lower back, it's a great stretch for the lower back, believe it or not, because it can open up the hamstrings and hip flexors to really release a little bit on those hips. So hang low, get the hamstring stretch, and get those hips nice and low, hang out in that squatted position. All right, and then you look at a three-year-old, five-year-old, and they can squat all day long. All right, but you look at a 35-year-old who's got a desk job, forget about it, right? There's no reason that should happen. You gotta keep working that squat. All right, high knees and heel kicks. Get back to getting that heart rate up a little bit. All right, nice range of motion. Now the body's a little loose. Blood's flowing a little bit. All right. So let's talk about the workout a little bit, shall we? Partners, like I said, two sets, set one, set two. Your main exercise on set one is gonna be your machine. Now you guys maybe don't have the machine at home. You got many things we talked about, jumping jacks, jump rope, go out for a 2-minute jog, something like that. But while partner one is doing A, partner two is working on B. And under set one, it's a Swiss ball, Bosu ball exercises. Again, a lot of these things should be done on the ground if you don't have any kind of ball. All right, so you work through those. And as soon as the partner A, we go to our one-legged reach. And I'll warm up here, second to last exercise. Once the partner one is done with their machine calories, whatever they do, then partner two gets on their own machine here. And partner one starts to work on all the Swiss ball Bosu exercises. Right, and you just gotta remember where you left off, because when you finish the machine, then you gotta get from your exercises to the machine, you gotta remember where it is that you left off. And just that's it, you go back and forth. They got about 4 rounds in at the 5 a.m. class, so that's what I am judging this on. 4 rounds is good, so 4 times in the machine, and then 4 rounds of doing your exercises, and then we do that again with the slam ball walk up slams. So if you get 4 rounds of that in, ooh, baby, that'd be awesome. Finish a little jack in the box, you can jump rope, whatever works, get that heart rate up. Whew. Alrighty. That's it, guys. That's it. We're gonna get warm. Get ready to crank this workout out. It's a good start to the weekend. Let's get this party rocking and rolling. Alright, I'm gonna check with these guys, make sure they're good to go. I'm going to answer any questions, but we'll be ready to go pretty fast.
talk about their workout that we trying to do. If you're pushing on exercises, we really want to refresh and get a So slight bend in the elbow. The elbow touches. The elbow does not. I don't know.
People, clock is on. We're starting on set one. Henry's got the calories. He's going to do 800 calories. No. Kidding. He's probably going to do 30. Sure, he threatened him not to do too many. All right. So as we are doing our machine, right, we got our push-ups on the ball. Incline push-ups. Decline push-ups. Decline. Decline push-ups. 10 of those. They just be down on the ground. If we down on the knees, doesn't really matter. Body saw is next. You can do that on the ground. You don't need the ball. Back and forth, 10 times. Good control on that plank. Good engagement of the core and spinal muscles. Did you read my post last night? I said, think about your spine. Control it. Engage it. Side plank crunch now. Again, on the ground, on a BOSU if you got it. Good control, five on one side, five on the other. Look at that nice straight line Sherry's got. Shoulders down through the hips and to the heels, not letting the hips dip at all. Good technique, good technique. Now she remembers what the shoulder twist is. Yes, and she's gonna add the ball. Oh, making it a little more difficult. Here we go, hips are up, and we twist back. And one, fourth, is two. Nice work, nice work. All right, next up is that V up ball switch. So you can do a V up toe touch if you don't have a ball. Uh-oh, ball's getting big. All right. I say on average two and a half minutes is a good time on that cardio machine. Let's see where we're at. Just over 2 minutes now. We got Mullen Walkers. You can do that on the ball. All right, mountain walker is a slow, controlled mountain climber. Perfect. Look at that timing. How'd you do? 30? How many did you get?
30-35.
All right, now we switch. Now we switch. Now Sherry's on to that cardio, and her partners are doing their push-ups. That's how it works. Nice and simple. Looks good, looks good. Alrighty now. Did you decide to do cardio first? Maybe you went out for a jog. Maybe you're doing jumping jacks. Did a combination, burpee, jumping jacks, jump rope. Or maybe you started with the exercises. Maybe you're gonna just do all the exercises and you save your cardio for later. You could do that. You can go back from the B is on set one to the B on set two. That's a lot of exercises. Plates of four. Henry's doing the shoulder twist with the plates. That's what we've always done them with in the past. Fun stuff. All right. So, yeah, pay attention to Henry here. All right, doing his exercises if you're doing the exercises with him. Be a ball switch is next on that. Sorry, I was focused on the cardio so much. We got that, we have other exercises going on. All right. All right, if you finished already the exercise, you start back up again. You go to the top. You just keep on going through it. Keep on going through it. Your ball switch goes to your mountain walker. Nice, good control on that plank. Nice job, nice job. Oof. So everyone's going to be moving at a different pace with this workout, right? Everyone does calories at a different rate. And everyone does their exercises at a different rate. So it's not always going to be perfect. You're not always going to finish your set of exercises when your partner has done the machine. But, you know, that's the challenge, to remember where you left off. All right. That's it. Back to our original stations. Henry's on to the machine. And Sherry is on to push-ups. Alrighty, nice work on those push-ups, feet up in the air. Now, if you're on a Swiss ball, if you have one, and the closer you roll it to your knees, you can get it up over the knees, you're gonna make your push-ups easier if you need to. Body saw is next. All right, good, strong, solid plank. Nothing should be moving but the shoulder joints, actually, right? Good control as you roll on the forearms up and back. Up and back, 10 times. Nice easy numbers, 10, easy to remember, right? Side plank crunch, and 5 on each side. Again, keep those hips up, looks good, looks good. Shoulder twist. All right, he's just keeping those hips up, engaging those glutes. And your shoulders are doing all the work as you rotate on that ball. Torso twist. Another name we used to call this. We've often had this exercise when we do our iso holds, right? You guys remember that? We do the twist and then we hold with 1 foot up off the ground. That's always a challenge. And our be a ball switch. Wow, looking at the weather today, looks like a beautiful day as we move into our mountain walkers to finish that set. Nicely done. Look at that switch. Woo. Good work, good work, good work. All righty. Working on nicely, working on nicely. I give everybody the option to choose whatever set they wanted to pick to start with. Everybody out there is on set one. I guess they wanted the machine out of the way. I guess they want those walk-up slams to finish. All right, we're on push-ups. 10 push-ups to your body saw. All right, nothing has to go too fast with these exercises, all right? It's only 10, so let's work on good technique. Let's work on good form. Let's work. Side plank crunch. Side plank crunch is next. We got our shoulder twist. Then goes to our V-up ball switch. You're really trying to get those shoulders up off that ground. Everything on the ground should be your butt. That's the goal. That's the goal. Really get up high. I always have in my head how I like these exercises to go and how I like to do them. And then I see other people do them. And I wonder, am I just so flexible that I'm able to get up? Am I that much stronger in my core? Do I just really want to do this exercise this well? Or do other people just don't have the ability to get up? The V-up ball switch is one of those exercises that I feel it's not that bad. But when I see everyone else not doing it, it's got to be difficult for them. So difficult that they just can't actually get it done. There's many exercises that I can't do that well, and many others can. So I'm always curious about that V-up ball switch. Are people just not trying as hard? Are they physically limited in the ability to be able to get up? Now, the other thing I'm realizing is that our calories, well, there's a big gap between 20 and 30 and 40, and I get that. And I used to think that had to be a hard, fast number. What's more important is you pick a number. Pick 30, pick 20. If those numbers aren't right, pick 25, pick 24, pick 28. I don't care. Just pick a number and go with it. That way you have a goal. If you just kind of go over 2 minutes, then it's like, ah, whatever. But if you say, all right, I'm getting 24 calories in, boom, then you get those 24 calories in, right? I like that philosophy. I like having a goal. I like having a number. And obviously, we have lots of timed workouts where you work for 30 seconds, work for 45 seconds, work for 60 seconds. But, and those are good. Those are good workouts because you've got to push for that amount of time. But it's good to have a number. It's like, all right, I got to do 10 of these, or I got to do 24 of this. And I think it gets a little extra work in there when you do that. That's why it's good when you mix it up. That's why it's good. Good to have that mixed up. Speaking of timed Fridays, I think we got that coming up next Friday. We'll do a timed workout. 30, 45, 60. Some fun things. Can you get all of our workouts set for Monday? Great help with Nina. Helps write these things up. We put them together. And bring them to you. Hope you guys like them. I know this week's been fun. Well, Monday, Tuesday was one of those workouts people did not see coming. They saw it just didn't look that difficult, and man, it was a tough one. right? Lots of people sore in lots of different spots. My shins were sore and calves were sore, jumping rope for 3 minutes. And then people's shoulders were sore, my hamstrings were sore. So, and then Wednesday's workout looked like a lot, but people were zipping through it, zipping right through it. That could be fun in and of itself. And then we got today, Partner Friday. Hope you guys are liking it so far. What do we got left? 6 minutes. 6 minutes on that clock. All right. Keep on working. Keep on working, guys. Nice job. And that's it. These go fast. These times on the machine goes fast. Woo. But man, I bet that heart rate gets up. That breath rate is up. All right, back on the machine for Sharon. Henry's on to his push-ups. All right, good technique. Elbows pointing back, chest to the ground. I like it. And let's look at Jen in the background, okay? She's got perfect technique. I don't care that she's down on her knees. Her chest is all the way down on the ground. Her elbows are pointed back. That is how you do a push-up. All right, it's a modified push-up, but that's okay. She's getting the full range of motion. I highly believe full range of motion is very important. Do whatever you can to modify to get that full range of motion, all right? And I'm working on getting suspension trainers up here so that you can help on getting people into their squat, deeper squats, full range of motion. If you're modifying it, if you have some help lowering down, you'll be able to get deeper into that squat. Range of motion, very important. That's why we stretch. That's why we open things up. All right. That's another thing I noticed watching my preview videos. I say all right a lot, right? All right, right? I guess everyone has those little idiosyncrasies. All righty. Been chatting a lot here. Henry's on to his shoulder twist. How are you guys doing at home? Hanging in there? Give a big old shout out to all my peeps who I know watch these regularly. Who we got? We got Sue out in Narragansett. We got Leslie, usually works out here in Wakefield. We got Larry up there in Saunderstown. Larry and Diane. Well, he might not be working out on Friday. I know he said he was doing the Wednesday workout on Thursday. So we'll see what he does the Friday workout. Very hard workers over there. We got Rachel here in town. Oh, she does a workout all the time. Juliana sometimes does a workout, but she's not up in New Hampshire in the lake house. All right. I know I'm missing people. I often get Roxanne, who actually works out at 6 a.m. with us. She's one of the few that is often here actually on the live Zoom call with us. Not today. I notice it's tougher waking up when the sun is not up when you get up. Does anyone else have that issue? All right, who else works out? Daniela working out in Narragansett. All right, your BOSU ball finally come in. You can do all these exercises on your BOSU. And these guys are already switching again. Alrighty, these guys are having fun out there, I think. I think they're having lots of fun. You having fun at home? I hope so. Woo! Henry's burning it up. He's getting that cardio in. Alright. Sherry did her push-ups on the body, so it's kind of tough to do push-ups and you're sucking wind. That's why we do it. All right, guys. Nice. Almost done here with our first set. We have about 2 minutes left on that clock. Let's work all the way through. Right, we're gonna shoulder twist. Right, again, the key on those, make sure those glutes are engaged. Hips are up. You can do a Russian twist on the ball. If you have a Swiss, if a Bosu ball at home, or just a Russian twist on the ground. And we have Russian twists coming up on the other side, but it's a good exercise, good spinal twist exercise, rotational exercise, that's good. And we have ball switch. Get those shoulders up off that ground. Come on. Ah. I know our balls are weighted, so it's a little more difficult to get up. But... All right, guys. Nice job. Nice job. What we got? On walkers. Good control. Get a nice strong plank. All right, guys, we're coming to the end of our first set. Set involves our slam ball walk-up slam. Walk-up slams. That'll take all 90 seconds, 2 minutes. And then we have a lot of dumbbell exercises. All right, so these guys figured it out. Since Henry started and finished on the cardio, he's gonna start on the exercises and Sherry's gonna start on the cardio for the slam ball walk-ups. All right, so she's got her walk-up slams, 20 of those. Again, take your time, nice steady pace. Now, if you don't have the slam ball, you're gonna have the ability to slam. Again, we can do a walk-up press. Walk-up press will be fine. If you can't do any walk-ups, knees are giving you issues, give me two reverse lunges for the press. All right, that'll work. That'll keep you on the same pace. As we're on to our exercises with the dumbbells, we've got skull crushers. We did 10 of the skull crushers. Side plank row is next. 5 on each side of your side plank row. Good, that's good. Lat pullover, all right? Lying down, shoulders on the ground, and feet just an inch off the ground. Bring that weight all the way up and over. So using your core, holding it nice and tight. It's really engagement of the core. It's not using it too much, but by lifting your legs off the ground, your lower abs are engaged and you're squeezing. And now by raising that weight over, your lats are being engaged, but your core has to be engaged in order for your lats to do all the work. So again, it's tightening up of that core, that spine, when you feel like your spine. When you think about your spine, elongate it, lengthen it, like someone's pulling on your head, but you're squeezing it at the same time, right? So the engagement, that's what we're looking for. All right, Russian twists. 10 Russian twists. Our sumo concentration curl. Get down low, 25 of these. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Look at that form. Look at that technique. Craven, love it. Low into that squat. Hips are just a bit below parallel. So fully engaged with all these squat muscles. And now the supine fly. Straight off, slight bend in that elbow. Oof. And get that good squeeze. Try not to let that elbow... straighten out. You want that slight bend so you're fully engaged. Ooh, 5 on each side. 5 on each side. He's going to finish up. All right, he wants to get this done before he works on the slam ball. Sherry is completely enjoying the fact that she gets to take a little rest. She second win before. Now she's all caught up. Beautiful. Beautiful. All right. Now Sherry's on to her slam ball exercises. Oh, Sherry's on to her dumbbell exercises. Henry is on to the walk up slamma jamma. All righty, guys. I'm going to go walk out. Get some motivation going on. Check how everyone is doing. I'll be back. Thank you. guess everyone seems to be doing pretty good out there. Moving. Looking good, looking strong. How are you guys looking at home? Doing good? You hanging in there? There you are. All right, looks like Sherry's giving me Henry the ability to finish his set before she goes on to hers. That's fine, though. A little respite here and there is all right. Left here of our second set. So three quarters down, one quarter to go. Working on those walk-up slams. Sherry's got her dumbbell exercises. She's cruising through them. Get those con curls going on now. Working on those biceps. Those supine flies. Whew. All right, these guys have their timing down, I think. Henry's done with his 20. And Sherry's finished with her dumbbell exercises. That's it. Good timing. All right, moving on, here we go. Gotcha. So far, it's looking good. Of course. All right, doing those side plank rows. Henry likes that little extra added lift of that top leg. That makes it tough. Alright, side plank rows, lat pullovers. Alright, nice work. Lat pullovers, go to our Russian twist. Checked and it is hot and humid again. We got almost 80% humidity, almost 80 degrees, that 80-80 number. Oof, man, just keep on going back and forth with the heat, the humidity, and well, we had a couple days of relief. It's a couple, I think Wednesday, Thursday, there's a little relief. As we move on to our curls here. That's all right. That's all right. I don't mind it at this point. End of August. Good reminder that the last little bit of the really, really hot stuff. Reminder that September is coming. One of the best months we have here in southern New England. It's a beautiful day still. A little less humidity. All good. All good stuff. Finish it up on supine flies. Supine flies. Five aside. All right, guys, looking good, looking good. Here we go. Walk up slams for Henry. Skull crushers for Sherry. She was doing that with her feet off the ground. That's an extra added twist to make it more fun. Side plank row. Five aside. Lateral pullovers. Russian twists. Sumo curls. All right, everyone's looking good. Everyone's looking strong. Nice, nice, nice. Almost there, almost there. 4 minutes. All right, I think Sherry will get in one more set of her slam ball walk-ups. And we'll get one more set of the dumbbell exercises in. Make sure he finishes up on the supine flies. Oof, that's pretty good timing, pretty good timing. All righty. Now Henry is on to skull crushers. Can't be seen, but he's got great technique. Elbow straight up to the sky. Handle of the dumbbell right to the forehead. Good extension. And we go to our side plank row. All right, well, Henry's going off script now, so I can't follow anymore. Doing more tricep exercises. Oh, we'll catch it at Sherry doing her walk-up slams. All right, now he's back on. Side plank rows. All right. Get it done, guys. Nice job. What are your plans for the weekend? I don't think about it. I don't want you to keep talking about the work. What are you guys doing? Looks like a nice weekend, right? Well, you guys know I'm going to be mountain biking at least once, probably twice. Get out today. Get out Sunday morning. Might hit up a ropes course. I know there's a ropes course at Mystic. I've heard great things about it. My daughter and I might go for a little stint. Climb some ropes. And I probably should do some yard work. It seems like I haven't done a whole lot of that lately. But when the weekends are so nice, it's hard to I had to focus on yard work, don't you think? Yeah. We'll see. Definitely spend some good family time. Hoping to get my son out on the trails today, get him mountain biking again. All right, guys, let's wrap this thing up. Come on, let's get it done. Last minute of exercise. All right, awesome work today, guys, awesome work. Put in some time out there. This is good. Woo. Nicely done, guys. Nicely done. This is a tough workout, I think. 40 minutes. Pretty solid work today, guys. Very good. You get all this way through the video. Good job. Still with me. Really appreciate you being here. I hope you enjoyed this partner workout, using us as your partner, or maybe you have a partner at home. Maybe you got a buddy at home somewhere you can challenge. Again, send them the video, send them the link, let them know they're welcome to do these workouts. They're fun, they're effective, they get the job done. Well, that's all I got for you today, guys. Again, I really do hope you have a fantastic weekend. All right, and we'll get back to it on Monday. Really appreciate you guys. Take care. Wait a minute, these guys are still working. Well, I don't know what they're doing, but you guys can be done. Have a great day.